So he said he said that they don't obviously they don't put anything, they don't add anything to the vineyard.
Mm-hmm.
But they also don't take the stuff out of here. So they take the vines, they drop them, they leave them on the ground.
Yep. Okay.
Yeah.
Wow.
It's an android.
An árbol.
Yeah.
An árbol.
It's a tree.
So they go through with hose, it looks like, to cut some of the, like, the grass around it?
Horses.
Horses, yeah. Okay.
Caballos, ¿sí?
Hmm?
Caballos.
Con caballo y con asadón.
¿Qué es este?
Es una herramienta que tú excavas con la mano.
It's like a hoe.
Okay. Yep.
Esas parras, hermano, son las más increíbles que yo veré en mi vida, y quizás ustedes, pero
sí.
Ahí hay, en cada giro hay 100 años.
In every parra, in every branch is,
yep,
¿cuántos años?
100 años.
It's 100 years old.
Okay.
Gira, la parra gira, el tronco, sí, gira.
Like the part, like the big parts that come out of the trunk.
Yep.
Yeah.
So like the vine itself is 200 years old, and then like
el tronco es de 200. Y esto es como 100. Sí. Los giros. Y estos
es del año.
Del año.
So did they grow another one?
No aplicamos nada. Nada en nuestra viña.
Sí.
Considero que el vino se hace en la parra.
Sí.
No es la bodega, es la parra. Uh-huh. Aquí es donde un agricultor hace su vino.
Yeah. So he said this
es país sin azufre, sin absolutamente nada.
Nothing. Yeah.
So he said that this is where he's like
the wine is made.
This is where the wine is made.
Yeah, not in the winery.
This is where not using chemicals really matters.
Yeah.
So I think what happened was like they cut this. Like 100 years ago, they cut some of those trunks back.
Yeah.
Or not the trunk, but the other part.
Well, the branches, yeah, yeah, yeah. I think eventually, like, the branches get unproductive.
Yeah.
Hmm.
Y todo esto país.
Does he do any thinning? Like, does he do any cutting of the leaves? Does he drop any of the, like, because they have, like, secondary clusters, you know?
No químicos, no químicos y la hueá perfecta, hermano.
So you mean, like, there's main clusters and then towards the end of it there's secondary?
Yeah, or, like, some people cut off some clusters.
No, nada.
None, okay.
No, nothing.
All right, okay.
Los hombres inventamos cortar nosotros.
Yeah.
Las parras son salvajes. Las parras pueden subir a los árboles y
sí.
Mira esa burra.
Yeah.
Perfecto.
Sí. See, he said that humans invented cutting.
Oh. Yeah, right. Yeah.
Está perfecta. Estoy feliz por la uva de este año. No puedo pedir más a la vida, hermano.
I don't understand Spanish, but I understand ooh la la.
Yeah. Dice que no comprende español, pero
no comprendo. Están en el piso.
No.
Hace 10 años.
Ah,
okay. This is the Naranjo. 2020 Naranjo. In open concrete tanks. They've got little spigots down here that you can pump out from.
Sí. No necesitas ser funcional. No. Para mí, jamás meto un vino funky en una botella. No. Sí. El vino natural es bien. No tiene por qué ser funky.
No, sí.
Es un mal concepto.
No, esto es porque es un momento en América, porque la gente joven quieren funky, pero no saben por qué quieren. No, yo sé, sí.
Correcto.
Están enseñando de la vida natural. Y primera, me gusta funky mucho.
Sí.
Y después de estar en Italia por un mes, después de Francia por un mes, tastando, y Chile, estoy enseñando que funky, no sé.
Adiós, funky.
Sí, adiós. Sí.
Es natural, es bueno, es bueno, hermano. Entonces, hay que empezar a ver que los vinos naturales buenos siempre van a estar muy bien. Y cada día, como natural, queremos ser mejores. Queremos que la gente lo reconozca precisamente por lo no funky. Porque el natural puede ser bueno y muy bueno. Y puede traspasar toda esa barrera que a veces es un poco negativa.
Sí.
Entonces creo, no, el vino natural es rico. ¿Por qué no puede ser rico, hermano?
Sí. He said that like the obsession with funky, just he doesn't get it. He's like wine, the actual wine is balanced wine, it's delicious, it's wine that you can drink. The funkiness is probably because people don't know how to make it well.
Yeah.
And they're excited about it. But it's because like it's the VA is high and the, you know, sort of bitter, like all of those things, like people are obsessed with those.
Right.
Yeah. The reality that's not what he thinks natural wine is.
Yeah.
I mean, this is
Gonzalez Bastias down here in Maule on the Maule River. You can see the Maule River right out there. I should have gone swimming in it, but there's the vineyards. Couple blocks over there, that big block of old, super like 200 year old país. There's Jose Luis walking through the center of it with his dogs, walking down probably to close the gate, make sure that we actually got out of here in our tiny little Citroën and didn't get stuck. It's pretty cool. It's very sheltered down here. It was super hot up there in the hills yesterday, but down in here, it's definitely, it's a little bit more, a little cooler, a little bit more protected. Pretty neat. That's it. That's the whole vineyard.